When you call me señorita, I wish I could pretend I didn't need ya. But every touch is oh la la la, it's true la la la. Your English teacher. The project for this week, recycling. Project number 3, week number 2. Let's start. Task number 1. Answer the following question by WhatsApp to your teacher or in your notebook. The question is there a recycling program in your community? If there is, describe it. If not, why do you think there isn't any? Task number 2. Listen to two friends talking about a new school recycling program. Then decide if each of the following sentences are T true, F false, or NM no mention in the audio. Okay, let's practice. Read the sentences number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. According for the audio, you classify is true, false, or no mention.
Guess what? My school came up with a new recycling program this year.
Oh yeah? That's so cool. Tell me about it.
It's such a great idea. So, in the halls of our school, we can find 3 different plastic containers in 3 different colors. Green, blue, and black.
And what do the different colors mean?
Green is for papers, blue is for plastics, and black is for anything that cannot be recycled. It's so simple, such an easy system to use.
And are your classmates really recycling?
Yes, it's so exciting to see them participate in the program. It takes a couple extra seconds to think of where to put each item you want to get rid of, but it's such a pleasure to see that we're helping out our environment.
My school doesn't do anything to recycle. It's so terrible. We need to do something. Do you think I can get my school to do the same?
Try it. It's so important to do everything we can to save our planet.
Task number 3. Lecture grammar. Watch a video and identify when do you use so, when do you use such.
This flower smells so good.
This is such an interesting book.
Oh, it's been such a cold winter. You've got such great style, Philip. I like it.
Thank you.
That dog is so annoying.
This is such a nice cup of tea, Philip. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh. You are so rude. That's disgusting.
Hey, everybody. So in today's class, we're going to talk about the difference between so and such.
Oh, but we forgot to take off the glasses.
Wow.
When can we use so?
First of all, you can use so with an adjective. For example, you are so beautiful.
Thanks. I know.
Or for example, I am so hungry. Or I'm so thirsty. So plus adjective is very common. You can also use so with an adverb. For example, you speak so quickly. Or you eat so slowly, Isabel.
Yes, I know. It's much better for your stomach. This is so good coffee. That could be a typical mistake. How would you say it correctly?
You'd have to say, this is such good coffee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is such good coffee. Or this is such a good cup of coffee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, this coffee is so good.
Oh, this coffee is so good.
Okay, entonces lo que hay que tener en cuenta es que después de so, nunca puedes poner un sustantivo ni un adjetivo más un sustantivo. En todo caso, lo tienes que cambiar, ¿no? Como this
yes.
coffee is so good. Y por eso tenemos such, de hecho, ¿no? Porque
yes.
such, ¿cómo se utiliza en inglés?
Pues usamos such cuando decimos una frase con un sustantivo o con un adjetivo y sustantivo. Por ejemplo, Isabel es una chica tan guapa.
Ooh, Isabel is such a beautiful girl. I don't think I can say girl. I am more like a lady now.
Bali es una isla tan bonita. ¿Cómo lo dirías, Isabel?
Bali is such a beautiful island.
Sí. Bali is such a beautiful island. If you haven't seen our video, you can go and watch it. We'll leave a link here. ¿Y cómo dirías, Isabel? Pero es un viaje tan caro.
Oh, yeah. But it's such an expensive trip.
Such an expensive trip. Yeah. También puedes usar such con un sustantivo sin adjetivo. Por ejemplo, limpiar la casa es un rollo.
Cleaning the house is such a pain in the neck.
Pain in the ass.
Oh, I didn't want to say that. Ah, another very typical one that you hear all the time is, you are such a fool, or you are such an idiot.
Yeah, you're such an idiot, you might say. Don't say that to your teacher. Yeah. You're such an idiot, or you're such a fool, or...
you're such a wonderful person.
Yeah.
You don't need to insult people. Okay, exactly. Any more examples?
Por ejemplo, podrías decir, it was such fun to see you yesterday. Or, it was so much fun to see you.
That's right. Yeah. So sometimes you use such without a.
Yes, if it's singular and countable, you say, it's such a beautiful day. If it's uncountable or plural, then without the a. Y Isabel, ¿cómo se dice tanto en inglés?
Tanto se dice so much, ¿no? Por ejemplo, sí. Uf, he comido tanto, estoy llenísima.
Yeah. En inglés, ¿cómo lo dirías? Dirías, I've eaten so much. I'm really full.
You can say, I feel bloated. Is that rude? It's not very nice. Okay.
Bloated like a balloon.
Okay.
Bloated, yeah. Or you could say, I'm full up. As well. ¿Y cómo dirías, Isabel, tantos, tantos?
Tantos o tantas, ¿no? Es so many.
So many, exacto. Es para sustantivos contables. Por ejemplo, comí tantas aceitunas.
I ate so many olives.
Mm-hmm. O, por ejemplo, bebí tantas cervezas.
I drank so many beers.
O bebí tanta cerveza.
I drank so much beer.
Yeah, beer, solo. Incontable, beers, como botellas de cerveza, contable. Pero un error bastante común es decir, en vez de so much, muchos dicen too much, pero eso significa demasiado. I like your videos too much. Suena como algo negativo.
Mm-hmm. When you have too much of something, it's like you don't want it anymore. You are tired of it,
yeah.
No? Yeah. I had too much of you. Get out of my house!
Yeah, exactly. Podrías decir, por ejemplo, he comido demasiado. ¿Cómo lo dirías?
I've eaten too much.
Now it's time to test your English.
What? Okay.
Your first question for £1,000. Tú conduces tan lentamente.
You drive so slowly.
It's the correct answer. Next question for £2,000. Can you translate this phrase? Era un libro tan interesante que no podría dejarlo.
It was such an interesting book that I couldn't put it down.
It's the correct answer!
Yeah.
Next question. If you get it right, you get £12,000. If you get it wrong, you go home with absolutely nothing.
Okay, I accept the challenge.
Nunca he tenido un dolor de cabeza tan malo.
I've never had such a bad headache.
It's the correct answer! Yeah! The next question is for £100,000. Las habitaciones en este hotel son tan cómodos. Cómodas.
¿Puedo usar el comodín de la llamada?
Okay.
Las habitaciones en este hotel son tan cómodas. Son such. So comfortable. Such. Comfortable? Ah. Okay, okay. Okay. The rooms in this hotel are so comfortable.
It's the correct answer! Yeah!
La boda estaba tan bien organizada.
The wedding was so well organized.
It's the correct answer!
Okay, Isabel, this is it. The final question. Quiet, please, in the audience. This is for £1,000,000. Quiet, please, in the audience. Can we have quiet, please? For £1,000,000, Isabel. Gracias por darme consejos tan 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 buenos.
Consejos. Advice. Thank you for giving me. Thanks for giving me such good advice, I think.
Is that your final answer, Isabel?
Yes.
I'm afraid it's the wrong answer.
No!
The correct answer was thank you for giving me such, 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 such good advice.
What kind of shitty program is this? Where is the money?
Very sorry about that, Isabel. Thank you for playing. Thank you. And, Isabel goes home with absolutely nothing. Isn't that sad? Well, we'll be back next week for another game of How Good Is Your English? See you next week.
It's been... Ay, que se me ha salido una baba.
Maybe move to the right.
Okay.
Thank you for playing.
Continue the activity number 3. It's a part of the writing. Write 4 sentences about things your school does or could do to help the environment. In 2 of sentences, use so, and the another 2, use such. Just write and remember the grammar rule. That's all. Thank you for this week.